The long, languid days of summer are perfect for preparing raw fleece. You've got plenty of time to let them dry and you can work in the sunshine. So if you're new here, my name is Becca and I'm a hand spinner, knitter, and I live in beautiful West Wales. And you're very welcome to my local woodland. If you're an old friend, then welcome back. I can't tell you how excited I am to find somebody who is within walking distance of me, who is producing fantastic fibre specifically for hand spinners. So I've bought a fleece from her and I'm going to turn the camera around and show you what I've got. So this is a Gotland fleece. It's quite a small fleece and it has been skirted. It came in plastic because it was all packed up because the lady I bought it off was sort of thinking I was needing it sent to me, and of course I live just down the road, so she literally just walked it down the hill to me. And I'm gonna unfold it so you can see how it is likely to come. It is pretty much all in one piece. There are a few mats in it and there's quite a lot of VM, but honestly I've never bought a raw fleece that doesn't have VM in it. It really doesn't bother me that much. So let's have a little look, and I am actually going to put my marigolds on to do this, but first of all I'm just gonna just sort of test it a little bit. So when we were talking about spinning in the grease, I said you don't want a heavy amount of lanolin. So if I just do that, it feels greasy but not sticky, and that's about perfect really, if I so desired to spin this in the grease, which I really don't. Okay, so marigolds on, just because, you know, they live outside in all weathers. They pick up all sorts of bits of stick and mud and who knows what. So let's just see if we can, yeah, we're gonna be able to unfold it quite nicely. So there you go. And hopefully you can see tail, head. But all the really nasty stuff has been skirted off. And yeah, it is a little bit matted together, but it's gonna pull out quite nicely. There you go. So, I'm just gonna show you my process for cleaning a fleece. You might have your own process. Love to hear them in the comments below, because I think it's really important to find what works for you. So this is my method of choice. I have a laundry bag and a tote. Now, if this was any bigger, I would split it in two and do two batches. But because it's quite a small fleece, then I'm gonna do it in one. And it weighs 1.3 kilos, which is roughly, so it's sort of 2.2 pounds to the kilo. Once you get the mud and the lanolin out of it, obviously it's going to be a lot lighter. So my first job is to put it in here and then I'm going to give it its first rinse. So I better get on with it. After downsizing to Pembrokeshire, I sort of decided I wasn't going to prepare raw fleece and I was just going to buy commercially comb top or carded fleece to work with. However, having made a video about spinning in the grease, it sparked a huge amount of interest and some really great comments. And I thought, you know what? I'm sure if I can find a small fleece locally that I can actually go back to preparing my own fleece to spin with. I like to use rainwater as much as I can, and we generally collect about 1,000 litres that we have stored, and it's absolutely ideal for this process. And it's gonna take quite a bit of water to actually get this fleece clean. I've half filled this with rainwater. Then I'm gonna add the fleece and then top it up as required. They're going to be nice and gentle. And this is just to get rid of the kind of the worst of the mud and the muck that's going to be in here. So I don't want to go crazy. So Gotland is long wool, a long wool breed. And most long wool breeds, the fleece does not felt particularly easily. However, Gotland is sort of the exception to the rule, so we just need to be a little bit delicate. Right, let's top that up.
Going to come back in a few hours and have a little look at that, but you can already see the dirt and muck coming out of it. This has been soaking for a couple of hours and I think it's about time to change the water. Wales generally has quite a wet climate, so I really wouldn't want to do this process in the winter, but on a sunny day this really is quite a pleasant way to spend your time. Now, I really recommend that you try and do this at a comfortable working height, because a fleece filled with water is very, very heavy. Now, back in the day when I had a bit more space, I used to have a great big ex-catering sink that was very, very deep, and very big, and it would fit a whole fleece in it, and I had a draining board at both sides. And so this really was not quite such a task, and then I could work inside without too much worry of it not drying and getting water all over the place. But this water will not go to waste, as you will see very shortly. This water is full of mud and sheep manure and is absolutely perfect for watering my fruit trees. You will really, really appreciate it. And it's a sort of instant liquid feed. So we've got quite a few fruit trees and fruit bushes in the garden. So all this waste water is going to go on them. Time for round two. So back into the tote and top it up with some more water from the water butt.
So whether you'll be able to tell that it's a bit cleaner, I don't know, but trust me, it's a little bit cleaner this time, and I'm going to do exactly the same process as I did the last time and water some more of the fruit plants.
Now I'm actually going to take this out of the laundry bag. There really just wasn't enough space in this tote, and I decided that in order to get it properly clean, I was going to have to change my process slightly. As I said before, I used to have this really massive sink, and so it wasn't such an issue. But this tote really is not quite big enough for what I want to do. Now I'm going to start gently moving this about, and imagine you're washing your very finest cashmere jumper. So you're being very, very gentle, because you really don't want to felt it. I mean, it shouldn't felt really, but you know, you just want to be a little bit careful, because the last thing you want to do is go to all this effort and then actually you felted it. I'm also picking out little bits of hay and straw and tiny little sticks, otherwise known as VM or vegetative material, and you just have to live with it. Sheep live outside and they do pick up bits of random hay and straw and thorns and prickles, and so you just have to be patient and pick it out. It is worth saying that if you're going to work with raw fleece, make sure your tetanus jab is up to date, because the last thing you want to do is to rip your hands open on a thorn that's in the fleece and find yourself with an infection. Better safe than sorry, you know what they say. So I've now actually split it in two, and you know, with hindsight, maybe I should have done that to start with. But I'm gonna treat each bit. I should just show you. There you go. So that's one half, that's the other half. I'm gonna treat them each separately and probably scour them broken down in half again, so in quarters. But you know, we'll see when we get to that point. So I've changed the water again, and I'm very glad I had lots of water in the water butt, because it really is using an awful lot of that stored water. So the next stage, I'm going to give it a wash with some of my wool wash. This is still with rainwater, cold water from the rain butt. And this is just going to start moving the lanolin out before I finally scour it in my washing boiler. So this is the first rinse, and you can see the water is pretty clear. I mean, there's still a bit of dirt in there, but by the time we've changed the water again and then I've scoured it, this fleece is going to be pretty clean. There's its final rinse. I'm going to walk the dog and leave it there, and then when I come back we'll have a little look at it. As if by magic, we're back, and you can see that is pretty clear. So I'm just gonna take it all out, leave it on the table, and I might scour it today. It really just depends what other things I've got to achieve. So there you go. And here it is in all its glory. And now I have got the very painstaking task of picking out as much of the VM as I can. And I'm going to show you how much there is. So I did know going into this that there was a fair bit of VM in it. And as I've said many times before, it doesn't really bother me that much. This is the worst area. But by the time you've kind of washed it and scoured it and combed it, and you know, you're getting rid of it as you go along. But I am going to sit down and try and pick a bit more of this out, because as you can see, it's well and truly in there. So here she is, Big Bertha, the washing boiler, and she's been in the shed, so she's a bit dusty. But I think I'm going to do
half a fleece at a time. We have half the fleece in there with some wool wash, and I'm now going to bring this up to about 80 degrees centigrade, which is roughly 180-ish, maybe 175 degrees Fahrenheit, and keep it there for about half an hour. Now, technically, that is actually my jam thermometer, but I'm using it for the wool, so I don't boil it. So here it is, drying on my makeshift rack. Oh, sorry, dog yelping in the background. So we're about 3 days after I filmed that, and the fleece is now dry, so I'm going to turn the camera around and show you what it looks like. It is beautifully soft, and you can see we've still got quite a lot of the curly locks, and some of them I think are going to be good enough to pull out and use as locks. I just sort of started carding a bit of it, and it's a lovely colour, it's very fluffy. So I guess the next video is going to be processing this. I've just also got some locks to show you so you can see the difference, so I'll just get those. So these are Wensleydale locks, so you can see they are actually quite a bit longer, but I think there's enough that I'm going to have something to play with, so I'm going to have fun with that. Now, it wouldn't be one of my videos without a little breath of fresh air. So Andrew and I were out and about actually taking photographs for our calendar that we make. And so I recorded this a few days ago, so I hope you enjoy it. Hello, and it is the longest day of the year, the summer solstice, and it's about 8:30 in the evening. The sun is beginning to sink behind me over at Strumble Head. Andrew and I have come up above Fishguard Harbour, and we're actually going to try and get a shot of the moon. It's not quite a full moon, it's actually full moon tomorrow, but today is a better weather day. So we're just going for a little walk, that's me and the dog. Andrew is back up near the car with his photography gear out taking some photographs. So I will turn my little camera, my little phone camera around and show you where we are. We're up above Fishguard Bay, and you can see the outer light and all the way to Cardigan. And just about visible in the distance is a shadow that is in fact the Llyn Peninsula in North Wales. The green has really changed from a slightly acid lime green of the spring to a verdant, rich summer green. And this time of the day, it's looking stunning. And yes, Andrew agreed to make a cameo appearance in this video, and he is patiently waiting for moonrise to get his shot. Gosh, the moon's really, really very pale. Yeah, it's really faint. After doing our moonrise photo, we pop down to Goodick just to have a little look and see what was going on, seeing if there was another shot that was good for the calendar. And it was really amazing. It was absolutely flat calm, and the smell of fish and chips was wafting across from the fish and chip shop across the way, and it felt like we were on our summer holidays. So this is going to be our fourth year of making a calendar for our friends and family. What do you think of June's shot?
Thank you for watching this week's video. Now, you know how YouTube works, so if you wouldn't mind subscribing if you don't, pressing the like and leaving a comment below, I'd really appreciate it. If you'd like to support my channel a little further, I also have a buy me a coffee option. It's just £3 and it really helps with the running costs of this channel. So until next time, have a wonderful creative week.